From the north side of the San Francisco Bay to Singapore, welcome to Urban X Real Talk Fitness Radio with your host, business owner, lecturer, author, master trainer, Tiaja. With over 30 years of experience in the health and fitness industry, he will challenge the fitness between your ears. So prepare your mind, body, and soul for the revolution of self-care, the evolution of fit. With real talk about real people, real health, real fitness, and the real deal behind our present illness culture. Real talk every time, all the time. Get weekly insights on how to shift your thinking, emoting, eating, training, hydrating, goal setting, and resting for you, the everyday athlete. You can cheat your fitness, but you can't steal your health flow. It's Tuesday, 9 a.m. Let's flow.
Welcome to Urban X Real Talk Fitness Radio, where we challenge the fitness between your ears. I'm your host, Tiaja. You know, it's hard to keep track of the number of lies we've been told by the food industry. They've misinformed us, sometimes out of ignorance and negligence, but oftentimes deliberately. What is the payoff, you might ask? Well, I'm glad you did. The food industry is controlled by only 10 companies. Almost every large food and beverage brand is controlled by them. They are as follows: Nestle, PepsiCo, Coca-Cola, Unilever, Danone, General Mills, Kellogg, Mars, Associated British Foods, and Mondelez. Each employ thousands, and each makes billions of dollars in revenue every year. They're not in business for their health, as they used to say, nor are they in business for yours. Indeed, they are not in the business of health at all, but come to think of it, neither is the health and fitness industry. Both the food industry and the health and fitness industry are in business to make a profit, whether that means profiting off of their carefully crafted food addictions or colluding in the creation of psychological and emotional self-image disorders like dysmorphia. Both industries put profit before people. With that said, today I'm going to share with you part two of Dr. Berg's lecture, How to Burn Fat. Most of what you're going to hear is common sense. Of course, there are also those things you didn't know or were made unaware of. So grab a paper and pencil or make mental notes, because what I'm about to share with you can help you gain control and get unstuck. Today will be just another day, unless you decide today that it won't be. It is Tuesday, April 16, 2019. Less flow.
Number one, carbohydrates. Now, you probably already know this, that low carb diets are very, very healthy. So you want to cut the sugar out, you want to cut the hidden sugars out. That does include the breads, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, pancakes, muffins, sodas, juice, alcohol, flavored yogurts, fruits, okay? Most people know that, some people don't. Number two, avoid combining protein with sugar. So if you were going to go to a restaurant and order a breaded piece of meat, or maybe it's a hot and sweet sour chicken, you know, from a Chinese restaurant, or like a hamburger with the bun, or a hamburger with the fries, or a hamburger with the Coke, that will greatly spike insulin way more than if you eat these separated, okay? Number three, and this is one that people don't realize, lean, low-fat proteins trigger insulin more than fattier proteins. So if you were going to buy like a burger, like some burger meat, and you had 95% versus 85%, and there's more fat, I would go for the fattier meat, because fat tends to buffer insulin. Lean protein, specifically protein powders like whey protein, that will spike insulin more. That's a new one. Next one, excessive protein. Large amounts of protein convert to insulin. So the ideal amount of protein is between 3 to 6 ounces. Okay, I hope you're taking notes. Next one, MSG, monosodium glutamate. What is that? That is a chemical that enlarges your taste buds to make the food taste more savory, to make it more delicious than it really is. All the fast food places have MSG in their food. Peruvian chicken, they put MSG, like a ton of it. And so there's MSG in so many foods in the grocery store. But here's the problem. It spikes insulin by 200%. Yeah, I know. So here you are. You consume this food. It tastes really, really good. But then all of a sudden, you notice the next day you just gained a bunch of weight because it spikes insulin. Next one is stress. So I wrote a book on body types. So the adrenal body type is the one with the belly fat, and that's triggered by cortisol. That's a stress hormone. But here's the thing. Cortisol doesn't increase the belly fat directly. It works through insulin. So stress increases insulin. Okay? And lastly, too frequent meals, too frequently eating. If you eat too frequently, like 5 to 6 times a day versus 2 or 3 times a day, that's going to spike insulin. Why? Because eating in general increases insulin. I know. It doesn't even matter what you eat. It's spiking insulin. So if you're grazing at night or snacking between meals, you're spiking insulin. So that's going to create, that's a hidden source of higher levels of insulin. Now, some of you are going to attempt these actions and you're going to lose weight, but you're not going to fully reach your goal because there's a condition that will prevent you from getting 100% results. Let me show you what that is. It's called insulin resistance. Insulin has become dysfunctional. It's become damaged to the point where it doesn't work anymore. The body is resisting it because there's too much of it. So it blocks it. People with insulin resistance have 5 to 7 times more insulin than normal people. So if you were to test someone with insulin resistance, they might have normal blood glucose, but they have very high insulin levels, but the doctors never check that. You would have to test a fasting insulin test, not a fasting glucose test, completely different, right? And insulin resistance is a pre-diabetic state, but a lot of times it will not show up on normal tests until it's too late and you become a diabetic, okay? So now let me show you the symptoms of insulin resistance. So number one, belly fat, despite how many sit-ups you do. You cannot lose your belly fat no matter what. Number two, you get plateaued despite eating healthy. Number three, when you eat carbohydrates, you feel better. It reduces your stress. You become less cranky. Number four, you crave sugar and carbs. Number five, a need for a nap after lunch. Number six, brain fog, dementia, absent-mindedness. You start lacking the clarity of focus, especially when you don't eat. Number seven, worse eyesight, especially as the day progresses. It's like you're, at night, your vision is worse. I mean, think about a diabetic. A diabetic, they go blind. Why? Because the blood sugars are needed to be normalized to actually feed the eye. So since insulin resistance is the pre-diabetic state, you could have vision problems well before diabetes, okay? And it's just bad eyesight. Next one, not satisfied after you eat. You need a little something sweet after you eat. Why? Because the cells are insulin resistant. They're blocking insulin, and so you can't get the fuel in the cell. So the cells are starving, yet you gain all this weight. You become fatter, yet you're starving to death. Next one, the need to urinate in the middle of the night. Wherever the sugar goes, the water goes. So in other words, you might have fluid retention, but you also might be just peeing in the middle of the night once or more than once. And that is that's a symptom of a pre-diabetic symptom of insulin resistance. Number 10, swollen belly as the day progresses. Do you find that in the morning your stomach is a little bit lower, but at the end of the day it's swollen up? Or maybe after you eat it just swells up? That's insulin resistance. So you can see insulin creates a lot of problems. Now, there are also dangerous long-term side effects of too much insulin as well. Heart disease, diabetes, as you might already know. A fatty liver comes from too much insulin, especially if the person doesn't eat or drink alcohol. It's coming from the insulin part. High blood pressure is too much insulin. That's why when you actually fix the insulin issue, the blood pressure comes down. High cholesterol, because insulin converts sugar into cholesterol and triglycerides. Stroke has been connected to high levels of insulin. Dementia is a little plaquing in the brain that stops the brain from working. And Alzheimer's, amyloid plaques it's called, that comes from too much insulin. So you could see that insulin is the common denominator for so many health problems that go beyond just belly fat. Okay, so the next question is, what do we do? Now, before I get into this, I want you to, if you've checked out, just check back in with me right now because I need your full attention because some of you might have brain fog from insulin resistance, okay? So the strategy is very, very backwards. we're not trying to treat a disease. We're not trying to treat weight loss. Medicine, healthcare, really is the management of symptoms. They're not getting you healthy. What's missing in healthcare is the health part. So what we want to do is we want to get you healthy, then lose the weight. We want to get the insulin system healthy. We want to get the hormones healthier so you have a chance to lose weight. So here's the question. Can you do it with food alone? That's a very good question. Maybe if you were to have all organic food that's from fertile soils, that from the farmer's market or the health food store, and you can make sure that it's grown on soil that's very, very healthy, you could probably do it. But here's the problem. In the U.S., the soils are so depleted. In the 1900s, the nutrition content was so much higher in America than it is now. And you can actually research that and find that. Think of the USDA RDAs. If you look that up, which I have, like the nutrition was way higher. Now it's depleted because the farmers have not been putting the nutrition back in. Now in Europe, people are thinner than Americans. I believe because their soil is richer, okay, with nutrition. In Africa, you know, the kids, and even Africans, they don't have teeth problems. They don't get cavities. They have perfect bone structure. In America, everyone goes to the dentist every 5 seconds and fills a cavity. That has to do with the richness of the soil. What makes the soil rich is the minerals. The minerals are necessary for vitamins to be made. So the plant can pull the minerals and make certain vitamins. Okay? That's how it works. Your food is only as healthy as the soil it grows on. Let's just take one mineral that insulin is dependent on, and that has to do with this one mineral called potassium. Potassium is something that you need in large quantities. You need 4,700 milligrams every single day. Now you might say, well, I eat a banana a day, so that should be enough, right? Bananas only have 300 milligrams. So how many bananas would it take to equal 4,700 milligrams if one banana is only 300? That's 15 bananas. You'd have to eat 15 bananas every single day to get your potassium requirement. Let's say avocados. Avocados are high in potassium, right? You still would need 5 avocados every single day. You would need 10 cups of vegetables every single day to get your requirement for potassium. Why is this? That's weird. It has to do with the soils. The soils are so depleted. Welcome to America. You're consuming empty nutrition. Even when you eat the food, remember growing up how the food used to taste really good? Now it's like empty, a tomato. And you go to maybe other countries, it's like rich. It's amazingly delicious. So the point is that this is just one little mineral. So that blew me away when I found that out. But it is the reason why it's causing our endocrine system to suffer and creating massive deficiencies in hormones and glands. So I did some research to find out what ingredient, what remedy that would be grown on organic, nutrient-dense soils that could provide enough nutrition to get us healthy. And this is what I found. Here it is, wheatgrass juice powder. Now why? Because wheatgrass juice powder has some amazing properties. First of all, 1 teaspoon is equivalent to 6 to 10 shots of wheatgrass. Also, it's equivalent to 1 tray of wheatgrass, 12 inches by 20 inches. So 1 teaspoon is equivalent to 1 tray of wheatgrass. It's incredibly concentrated. It's 100% organic. There's no gluten, no GMO, anything, no preservatives. But this is what's cool. It's grown in an ancient seabed. That's an old ocean floor that has all the dried trace minerals, the salts. So when this wheatgrass is grown on that soil, you get incredible properties of minerals that have been pulled up into the plant. Talk about a fertile soil. It's incredible. Now, recently, I've upgraded my wheatgrass to this right here. So what I did is I added a type of organic wheatgrass. It's called Kamut. Kamut wheatgrass has additional health benefits. It's loaded with the antioxidant called selenium. It's loaded with amino acids that are even more than regular wheatgrass. It's loaded with healthy fatty acids and a lot of other nutrition as well. And this wheatgrass was originally This wheat berry was originally used by the Egyptians long ago. There's also some really good research that supports wheatgrass and even the chlorophyll in wheatgrass in relationship to supporting healthy blood sugars and supporting healthy insulin levels.
Now here are my 2 cents, and feel free to keep the change. What you believe is the difference between success and failure in anything. For instance, if deep down inside you feel you are unworthy of being healthy and having the body of your dreams, then you'll never achieve either one, no matter how hard you work out or how conscientious you eat. It's like a person saying they want to have abundant wealth, but inwardly they think all rich people are evil and criminal. But here's some real talk. Your self-talk and subconscious thoughts will overpower your conscious thoughts and outward behavior. Just as you train your body, you must learn to train and discipline your mind so that the negativity of the world doesn't taint your self-belief, because it will. I always tell my clients that either you are training your temple or someone else's. That is, you're either training you or you're being trained. There really are no other options. What I'd like you to take away from this series is all the little doable steps you can begin to take every day to begin owning your health rather than renting it from the world. Dear friends, I wish above all things that you prosper just as your soul prospers. You've been listening to UrbanX Real Talk Fitness Radio with your host, Tiaja. Until next week, as always, walk in health and peace.